Game number two between Lonely Conspiracy and Priest Gaming for the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament. This tournament is for Save the Children, a charity organization that helps out children all around the world. And we would just want to give them some extra attention here, some money as well. And, well, keep all of that in mind here, as this is game two. Lonely Conspiracy, they got a bit too strong of a pushing lineup in game number one, and Priest wasn't really able to do anything against it. But this game, let's see what they bring back to the table here. As we actually see Oracle picked up Morality. What do you think of all of this?
Oracle, well, I'm going to say it outright. I think he's cancer to play against. And this could be an interesting test of Priest's abilities to see how they can handle this. False Promise, while being nerfed, still is a very, very, very potent ability that you cannot neglect. And of course, Purifying Flames being one of the best nukes at level 4, I believe.
Yeah, it's just one of the best nukes because of the slow, or the low cooldown. It's, you can just spam it all the time.
360 damage as well. It's like, come on! You want to make it even better? Fine, give Oracle an Octarine, Jesus.
That's just ridiculous, man. Don't be ridiculous. Also throw an Aether Lens. Like, getting an Aether Lens from Oracle is just disgusting.
Oh, yeah. Let's just give him max cast range. Come on.
You're getting it! You're getting it! You're getting into the flow of the things here.
Yeah.
having that said here, okay, like... For real, False Promise is nice, but at the moment, if you're locked down, it just keeps your life longer. Usually,
yeah, sure.
Once it's casted on you, it's just to prolong your life for 5 more seconds and then still die. Unless you have some Omni-Night-Dazzle combination behind it.
Of course, I mean...
If you don't have extra sustain...
The real promise of False Promise is the fact that in the late game, it can keep the carry alive for 9 seconds longer than he should be, you know? In that case, it can be devastating because the carry cannot die in that case. What do you do? You have to keep him locked down, and I mean, an Ember Spirit and a Magnus are great for doing that, don't get me wrong, but what if you cast it after all those abilities are used? At that point, you have to consider, great, the carry's allowed to go crazy for 9 seconds, and you know how much a carry can do in 9 seconds.
Destroy your entire team. That's it. It does mean that you tend to go for a little bit of a late game oriented carry though.
Of course.
And against a Magnus Ember Spear, that's already really scary to do it. Like, this combination can defend, like, the previous game, Priest didn't really have anything to stop a 5-man push early on, the death wall.
Yeah.
Now they have a Magnus Ember Spear. That combination is pretty strong against it already. Ember just needs some levels. And then they can do it.
I mean, this is a combination, and now the Tusk as well. These are all combinations that are geared towards, if you want to push us 5-man, we will punish you, and we will punish you very hard.
Yeah, I don't know, did I talk with you about it, about the Magnus with Empower on Tusk?
Not really, I don't think you did.
When you pop Warrior Sponge?
Yeah.
Empower still.
Power. Oh yeah, you deal like cleave damage with the Warrior Sponge.
Yep, so if you, let's say, if you have a Tusk position 1, 2, 3, whatever, you get some farm, and you're actually able to farm up, let's say, a Battle Fury or something, well, that's nasty. Just so nasty.
Well, I don't think they're actually going to do that. It is something that you don't want to fight against, shall we say. Magnus-Tusk combination is... potent, don't put it in that way. Even if you don't have an upgraded Walrus Punch, like in the form of more damage, it can still be a lot of damage with the 350% crit and the Empower. It's still a lot of damage being dealt to a few people.
If they're close, yeah. That's Tusk also strong against Beastmaster, just for the sheer fact of saving someone that's being roared.
Yeah.
You have to watch out a bit with that at the same time. Let's see if Lon's experience right now. There are some different routes you can take here with the Beastmaster Oracle. It's not really giving too much away. Oracle is still okay in the lane. Not the best of harassers, so it might pick up a secondary support that might be a bit better at it. And Beastmaster will most likely be the offlane or mid lane hero here. Will be okay against Magnus in mid as well, so might be able to pick up something else. Let's see. If London Conspiracy, let's say they need an offlane and support right now. Let's take a look at this first. Well, okay, that's the position 1 Lycan taken. Keep in mind,
that guy has had a comeback in this meta.
Yeah, what was Shane? Shapeshift now gives an aura to himself and his creatures with crits, meaning that now also Necrobu gets a crit.
Which is very scary.
Let's check real fast. Everything
matters
to pro, right?
It is.
So let's say if you also actually pick up a HOD or something, you take over a creep from the jungle.
You can push so hard.
Yeah. Just take over the alpha wolf as well.
Oh my god, stop!
You get the back leader aura, man, that's...
Not only good at pushing, it's good at fighting as well.
Yeah, it's just so hard to deal with. That's a pretty long cooldown, so...
Yeah.
You can like fight for 35 seconds and you're like down for a minute.
Which is okay. I mean, the 35 seconds, if you can do the most with those 35 seconds, then it's great. It's actually 18 seconds.
Yeah, that's it.
You know,
he's some levels of Oracle as well. His skills, his ultimate, just skills too strongly. They need something to guarantee Oracle something. With Lycan, he could go into the jungle, of course, so he can maybe take over the lane. But still, he needs a bit more. He needs to get level 11 at least. And he needs to get like 20 minutes. Because if he doesn't have it before that, he's most likely just going to keep on dying. Something he needs to look out for.
Ooh. Both teams, not really. I mean, this is going to be an interesting game from the get-go. Either it's going to be over very quickly, or it's going to drag out for quite a while.
Yeah, I think Priest are okay with going late. They're most likely to be picking up some kind of control in the offlane here.
Nope. They'll go for the mid laner.
It's
or
gonna
not.
Be Lina.
Or not.
I think this is support.
Probably mid lane and offlane Magnus. I mean, you might
you
do that.
You can do that, yeah. But Tusk is safe lane. It's okay against if it's a Beastmaster. No, even again. Beastmaster is okay.
This is
And they need something extra arranged if they... As a secondary support now for Priest. They need something to keep the... Let's say Beastmaster out of lane. If they don't pick up a mid lane here for London Conspiracy, that's... I think, yeah, London Conspiracy is going to leave their mid lane for the last pick. Like, they can always put Beastmaster in the offlane. So they can after the last pick.
You know, it's funny. I'm so used to just seeing all the mid laners being banned out in the banning phase. Like, in all the banning phase. I'm looking at it right now, and the only real mid laner that's been banned out is Invoker. The rest are still in the pool.
Yeah, you can go old school, get another quad going your way, or...
Old school, that was like two patches ago, mate. Old school.
Last patch before that, that's old school. That's old.
That's old school, okay.
It's old school for me.
Yeah, the undying, man.
I'm young, living the time, man. Living the time, man. They go back for the undying here. This is not showing their lanes.
No, not at all.
Like, you can even do Beastmaster undying off lane, have Oracle Lycan on top. Like, nothing at the moment is really punishing their lanes. If Freeze wants to do that, they can't even do it anymore because there's an undying. Making
the mind
it so
game's
hard.
Surreal.
Yeah.
Like, Priest has no idea what to do now. They ban out the Viper in desperation, I guess. Well, to be honest, it's a good idea. I mean, London Conspiracy are missing an obvious mid laner, and Viper in itself
is strong against Lina out and Magnus. So they're just looking about taking it out. Honestly, for LC, I wouldn't even be mining and the Queen of Fate too much here. Can do a lot. Maybe even Windranger. Doesn't. Really just depends on what they want to do. Are they gonna just keep up with this 5-man death ball here and pick up something that can just go and push all the time? Or not? And Priest, they answer back here with the Naga, so... Well, if Priest has their way, this is gonna be in a long game here. And they're just setting up to against LC to just, you know, make sure that they can't push too much. It does show that Ember Spirit is gonna most like... No, Naga or Ember can both be in the middle. I guess Beastmaster both are pretty much the same.
At this point, it does mean that Priest has a lot of delay, if you want to put it in that way. They can delay London Conspiracy a lot. Just with Naga, you know, her ulti is able to delay them. Lina's able to hold the pushback slightly, not the best. Ember Spirit is good for that, and Magnus, of course.
Also, Naga is a pretty classic counter against Undying. 5 seconds
remaining. Not much an Undying really can do. Oh! Okay.
It's more that you drop down the tombstone and then you can kill it off.
Yeah, with the illusions.
Yeah, no, you can just kill it off with everything. Like, you just walk up to it and hit it. The tombstone is not protected once song is popped. So the only thing
Right, yeah,
the only thing is there is the tombstone. You can just kill it off. But yeah, Leshrac, that's the one you were commenting on. This is just showing that, again, they want to push early.
Oh dear. Like I said, once again, this match could be over very quickly if LC get their way, or it could go late if Priest get their way.
Yeah,
or
after
we could meet someone in the middle.
After 35 minutes, I think LC might have all just GG out, to be completely
unless
honest.
They have, like, a huge lead. And in that case, they should have ended it a long time before. 35. Let's see. We don't know what's going to happen. We never know what's going to happen.
Indeed. As ladies and gentlemen, this is, of course, game number 2. Ooh, I got a lag. Okay, now everything's good. Having that said, this is, of course, game number 2. This is the grand final between London Conspiracy and Priest Gaming here. The winner will be winning about 160 euros. Loser wins absolutely nothing. With me is Morality. I'm Sender. We have 3 giveaways. Read all about them in the Twitch chat. Everybody's already doing the raffle thing. Make sure to also put out a donation here.
If we you have donate... an anonymous donation, but he's anonymous, so he's not getting the Arcana. Whoever you are.
That's me.
The $2 anonymous donation was you.
No, not two.
Okay. Anyway. As we see Kefka aggressively pushing into the Radiant Jungle. With the team of his backup, so aggressive warding going on here. As they will ward off the easy camp. However, Priest should be able to spot this one out pretty easily.
Yeah.
No issues there.
They're just also ready here. They just want to wait if some of them walk up and then just gank them straight away here with the 3 heroes. Question is, does Priest know that? They know there's something is placed. Gatorox seems to be willing to take the risk here. Picking him out to start walking, but Gatorox is still on time. He can turn around.
And he does. LT goes as well. The early push doesn't, all it really does is secure the maroon and fine.
Does give them maroon, gives them some control on bottom lane as well. So actually go for an aggressive tri lane here. This is a way again to punish Kree. Just put a tri lane against it with them dying in it.
Then he got to with the wards. This is weird. That's not something you see every day. Isn't she supposed to be position 1?
No, I guess it's gonna be support. I'm gonna put Dusk in position 3. Support Naga.
Okay, then.
That's greedy.
That is incredibly greedy. This could backfire horribly.
Yeah, this was also not the mid lane I was expecting from the side of LC. I was expecting something to do against the...
Okay, both teams completely slapped us in the face with a... With
yeah, they do...
Here.
They're doing something else. Completely different and...
Although this Undying will definitely help. Aggressive tri-lanes are, of course, Undying's forte. As we see here, the Purge comes out. There's the Lightning Storm. The double Undying stacks will help. But 40 health, Getrox able to get away.
Indeed. I would say also nicely are to keep Solon back. And this is just not the place to be for Getrox here. An Ember Spirit is not good against the tri-lane. At least not in the early levels. He needs to get level 4 before, or maybe even 5, before he can really do anything against it. And even then... You can purge off the flame guard.
What is Senegata doing though? He's being a bit aggressive.
Oh no, LSA on time here on Jellipy. Not able to get off the lightning storm here.
This is going to be a pretty difficult lane for Priest, shall we say. Because just this, the aggression that can come out from the side of LC is going to be very hard to fight against.
Indeed. They're just going to keep it up as well.
In fact, it's stuck here, camp here. No, that's a bull, actually.
Yeah, that's a bull. They moved the camp close to it, but I think they stopped it here.
Nah. Too early.
Oh, what? Getrox? He might just be in a weird position here. Yeah, they're gonna charge up the purge here. They don't really want to commit too much to it.
Yeah, there's not enough damage really to take him down, as he has only been paid once.
Well, we're just all looking at the bottom lane. Let's just take a look around at the other things in the middle. At the moment, Magnus is pretty much just dead even against the Lycan here. We'll get some wolves up now. We'll annoy him a bit, but should be still okay. And on the top, let's see how it's going here. Kev, guys. It's going pretty strong here. It's out CSing Poe a bit. Has a double boar right now, so that will make it hard, especially with the hole popped. But even then, Poe should be able to stand his ground, get experience, and get a little bit of CS here.
Ooh, he might actually...
No, he should be okay. Shorts.
The ball doesn't do enough damage to warrant anything. He's even going to get the ball? No.
He has a stout shield. That's just making it a little bit too hard for him.
As we go back to watching the bot lane, I've just noticed something. Undying went double mango.
Gotta get the mangoes, man. Gotta get the bumped up mana regen going.
Oh no. Denigata is not having a good time here. The double pull does succeed, but unable to really abuse it.
This is not a double pull. This is just a single pull.
This is just a single pull? Oh, you can't.
Yes. Did get a donation in here, though. Where did it go off?
Rogue. Well, finally, $3 is the number to beat, guys, if you want that lovely little Zeus Arcana.
My Croc. I hope he left in a note here with the Twitch name. Might be a bit hard, but I'll find you. I'll find you somehow. You will get it. If nobody beats the $3 here. €3, actually. For the Zeus Arcana. So, all the lanes are going quiet right now, and this is kind of what priests need. Even though they're not getting a whole lot on bot, once they get some levels, they can easily get some kills back.
Although, Gintrox only has 9 last hits. There's a rotation coming in from the Magnus here. Did he want to clip someone here?
Oh, no, they don't, but they're just dealing the damage and a kill of Bieber. LSA comes out, connects on Solin here, but they need to get a tombstone now. They will be able to do so. They keep on going after Dragonslave connects, does barely a pretty bare amount of damage here. So they will be able to get to the tower. They want to dive it, Zenigata does have a lot of armor and it's pretty strong, but Justin is taking the tower damage and it will be too much for him. Zenigata needs to get the kill, but he's not able to do it. The soul rip from Solin keeping him alive. And now the body blocks. Oh, being dead for Lycan here was not too bad. Easy body blocks going off from him. They turn it into 3 kills for himself. I think there were 5 kills overall.
Yep. The Undying falling pretty early in that fight. Or was it the Undying? Late. No, not the Undying. My mistake.
Oh, they're gonna go after Jellybee now. They're able to connect with the net here. Where's the follow-up lockdown? There's gonna be the form of body blocks, but it's not gonna be enough. Dragonslave doesn't deal enough damage.
The stick MVP item here. And it will help out a lot, just because you can keep getting stick charges every time Zenigata does anything.
Indeed, and Scottish guy, he just donated 18 bucks here, 19 actually. Almost, and he is giving it to save the children here, and with a smiley behind it, I'm pretty sure he just wants to do Zakena. But still, thanks for the donation, man. So at the moment, you want to beat it? 19 bucks, you get the Zeus Arcana.
And Gedrox is taking a lot of hate here.
Dead. That is too much. Purifying Flames in the end from Oracle to secure the kill. For as much that they needed it to be secured.
So 4 minutes in and already the action begins. Three minutes of passive is basically just waiting for the powder keg to explode here. And that's exactly what's happening. As Jellybee gets a good combo off, but will he be able to pull it off the kill here? I don't think so, as Gedrox does move in. Zenigata has been purified here, but the problem is the damage is not enough. There you go.
And Solin, what is he doing? He's just leaving Bivir here right now. Okay, well, he will soul rip him now.
Oh,
he was just
God.
Looking. He was looking to heal up Jellybee, but with that, he just completely leaves his own teammate all alone. And that was a mistake. He should have been getting off 3-man DKs here, and now Justice also comes in. Looking to get more on the top also.
He's 20 seconds on a skewer though, he can't really do much.
He needed a searing change to get off his ultimate here.
Oh,
Jellybee,
they might actually,
a snare.
Jellybee's low.
Are they able to get it in here? Get Rock? Oh, he just walks
off.
Oh no, Giga, no! That's not gonna work out, he's gonna go down. And it seems that they're not ready yet. Lycan is looking for me. Zenigata is gonna be found, he's gonna net him now. But he just spawns more wolves and keeps on going after him. And Ember, you can't help him. You can't. Leave him alone. Zenigata, he will fall here somewhere down the line. No, he won't. They see Gedrox and he doesn't have a random. Like I said, he shouldn't have gone there. But now the ultimate comes out from Justice. They're actually able to punish this. And now Jellybee walks in aggressively and he will be found. Are they able to get him off? Oh, they're going to be able to get the split earth. He wasn't even alive himself, but no. There is going to be Magnus killing him off. With
the
his
action
shockwave.
Is just immense. There's so many long fights going on. I mean, this is really what Dota is all about, isn't it? Priest able to take to leap ahead though, with 1,000 gold swing going their way.
Kefka? Did he want? No, he doesn't have money for this one.
And even though, I mean, you have those prolonged fights, and
Even though they may end badly for some people in some situations, overall, it does make for much more interesting game here. Problem is, LC can
Giga,
really
he's found again and killed.
Problem is, like, LC, with every fight and with every kill they get, is just great, because all they want to be doing is delaying Priest from getting to the late game.
At the same time, as long as Priest are able to not lose too much, it's kind of that's what they want as well. As long as they don't lose too much towers, too many towers, it's just going to be okay for them.
Oh no, get they, drops.
Again, not level 6, just needs 100 experience, he's not able to get it. They're going to turn it around to Genopi, though he's ensnared, and it just takes so long. And he will go down, and at the same time, now the Tusk comes out, comes in with a snowball, punches Biver up into the air, and he will go down now. These shards do not connect. The career, okay, we'll skip. They're rotating everybody here.
Another one for Priest hit, as they do are able to stop the push onto the tier 1.
Get another 700 gold to go in their way as well. Same time, Baby Knight hasn't really been able to take the tower down.
Gedrock's on his own now versus the Lycan. He's only level 5 though, so he's not much he can really do at this
point. He needs one creep, he will get it. There you go.
There you go. Level 6.
Does he
want to
go aggressive for this? I don't think that's the play, and he knows it as well.
Wolves are just too strong. Look at this, they're dealing so much damage to him.
Yeah, the cripple is also real. The damage over time from that is pretty nasty. Giga? What? They're leaving this ward. They know people are coming in, that's why. Oh, no, no. Okay, Biver is dead. Not level 6 just yet. Keeping himself alive, though! Oh, the plague there! But it's not gonna be enough. He's, in the end, still gonna go... No. This totem is not the play zone, and you're just gonna give it away now. Here we go. He's gonna get killed. There's a TP in...
Ooh.
Kefka, though, he's gonna get killed. They need to get a totem down.
Gonna die here. Senegoth is probably gonna die here.
They need to micro the Necronomicon Archer. But is it in range? It's just not in range. He's not able to get it off. No, Senegoth, he will try to deny himself, but there are the wolves, and there is the kill with Baby Knight.
Well played. For both sides.
And with that, all the early aggression coming out, or at least the good trades for priests, are just gone. They get 3 kills going away. Might even get Gedrox here. No, Remsworth picks up the regeneration rune as well, but the cripple will stop it immediately. That's not the good thing for him. He has to bottle it all up. He has to go back
and
to base.
The wolves are just going to keep following him. He's got the remnant, so he's able to get away from this if it does get a bit too hairy, but, you know.
He should just put remnant down in mid and walk back to base. That would be...
This is absolutely not good for Priest, though. I mean, Gedrox being this far behind is... not good. Not good at all.
He needs to... It's expected though, like... It's what you're playing against. He's not the one who needs to get you through this phase. This phase is all about the Magnus and the Tusk.
And they're doing fine. They're doing just fine.
Yeah, Justice just needs to get his Blink Dagger, and I think then you're gonna see some more aggression coming out from Priest, just making space.
Oh, hello, Rainbow Disco Pony. How are you doing? Giga not with level 6 though, so not much that can... That
yeah, once you get level 6, they can do it. Tusk just needs to make sure he's out of experience rates. Oh, Jellipo. Oh.
Level 6 now for Venus, so...
Good call on level 5 there, though.
I wanted to see if the XP thing works for the casters. Apparently it doesn't.
No, it just shows the level.
Yeah.
Anyhow, he's level 6 right now, so... They're gonna maybe look for something here. If Solon walks out too aggressively, they just pop him. There's more enough damage to just kill him instantly. Same time, Kefka on bottom gets off the roar here. Gedrock taking a lot of damage. He's not able to remnant out here in time as he goes down. And now Zenigat is going to be on the menu. He's trying to TP out. Is he able to make it in time? He is not purifying flames. Level 3 is just too strong.
And Kefka is very happy with this. Necro level 2, almost about to be level 3. He just only a bit of gold for that. So they can really start now forcing the towers here hard. Especially with the Lycan now building up towards, I'm not even sure.
Well, building up towards his death as he goes down here. They pop him. Giga using his ultimate pretty much immediately here with a nice smoke and coming up into mid.
There's actually nothing Lycan is building at the moment. Like, all he has is power treads right now. That's not revealing at all. Oh wait, no, there. He's building up a Vlad. Which is standard, really. Going to get that semi-early Rosh here.
Yeah, they do have a lot of minions and stuff to do it. Also, Jellipy has... it's been maxing Diabolic Edict.
So, which is, you know, tower push. It's all about...
Tower push and Marshall. Both.
Yeah.
Solon, you know, being an undying is always good around the pit.
What LC is saying is...
we missed you, Deathball. Can you please come back? We want you to come back.
They just need to get up one good fight here, then they can take Roshan or an objective, or maybe even both if they're fast enough. Hawk pretty much hated here. Oh, Tombstone going out. They want to try and turn him around
this
here.
This is not good. Why did you have to use up the orb? Probably not the best at base. 20 seconds for the punch.
Yeah, that cooldown reduction is hard on him. And now Naga is found, doesn't have a song. He's gonna go down instantly here.
I don't think the song would have helped that because he was just stunned up too hard.
Now Gedrox, he doesn't have a remnant, he has to look out here. Okay, they're not gonna follow this up too much.
It's like interesting the way Gedrox plays. He doesn't place down escape remnants. Like in this case, I would have placed down a remnant at least by the tier 3 just in case things get hairy.
Or tier 2 since you were there, but.
Yeah.
And now they're gonna just go into Roshan here. They just need, like I said, just need to get one good fight and they can do it. But the problem is, this might not be the best of fight yet. You just got one down, it's already respawned. They're taking it fast. It all depends. Are they gonna get off this? Justice is too late. He can't get in. He's even skewering away here. It seems there's nothing. Bone, what?
He gets the Aegis. He blocked them off perfectly in this case, and this could be the turner. LC is falling apart. Seems his Sonnen is not able to do much.
He does stay alive for now, though, but it's not. Is it going to be enough? Purifying Flames is sticking him up, but at the same time, they're going to find more. They already get the Lashback here as well, and now finally he goes down.
That was an Aegis steal for the Bugs.
All of these zombies and the wolves, they're too much. They're gonna get Lina in return, but still, this is a great fight here for Priest. Denying the Aegis. Do they even have it? I think it's
they have it.
They still what?
Yes.
Bone has it.
They can just take an objective really easily here. There's nothing stopping them right now.
Yeah, there's no spit push going on either. Jellypee is not at the tower yet. And even then, Diabolic Edith is on cooldown.
Although, now everyone's coming back. This could be actually.
No, this is okay. This is okay for Priest. They still got two ultimates up.
True. Just noticed.
So, if they go in, Zenigata just pops a song and they just get in place for a nice RP. Or just initiate with RP. And if it still gets messy, you can still storm away.
See, I was watching the Roshan that fight, and it really looked like Baby Knight Miss Microed here was just sort of stuck trying to get the Aegis, because they did take Rosh down, but the problem is they were blocked off by, what was it, Shards?
I was already watching the fight. I was honestly just expecting someone to pick it up somehow.
Like, yeah, but no, it's just Tusk just walks in and it's like, I'll just take that quickly, thank you very much, and we'll just turn around the fight on ya.
Yeah, that's usually when you take Roshan, you have one person just standing in Rosh itself. So you can instantly
just
click on
case,
it.
Just in case, like, situations like that don't happen.
Yeah, or if somebody comes in and tries to steal the Aegis, so you're in the middle of it, so instead of taking the Aegis, he attacks you. Like, there's, for reason. Oh, Zenigata though, he's level 6. This is not the easiest of getting. They need to get off the roar. Oh no! They're gonna connect on here. He needs a song. He's able to do so. TP's out immediately.
Still, song's down, and it's only level 1, I believe. Yeah, so she's only level 6. I just noticed. Wow.
Yeah. Well, that's okay. It's still support. I don't think he would have gone level 11 or 16 minutes anyway. That said, they need to do something out. Smoke was popped, and as well as the Necro Book number 3. So they need to get a tower here, and they will be able to do so.
This is an important tower, denying Rosh control is always nice.
Justice can't get close enough. If he gets closer than this, he would just be popped by a zombie.
They're pulling the Tusk in, but Tusk gets like a triple stun here.
Yeah, and he has the Aegis, so he doesn't care too much about it, even if he dies, but he will just stay alive here. Now Jellypee goes down, and Bone is still going strong. They will lose Gedrox here.
Look at the Lycan going crazy on the back lines. That's the aura for you guys.
And at the same time, yeah, Gedrox comes back, triple kill him. Well, Baby Knight will just mean that he's gonna give his dominating streak away here. He goes down, they need to do something here. It's a 2-for-2. Gedrox did go down and bought back. They need some more kills here for Priest, and they're gonna get more. I don't think Wyvern can live here unless they have. They need to stop it! They're not able to stop it! And now Solo, yeah, Solo's gonna die here. No, what?
What? They didn't get the snowball off quick enough, I guess?
They did not? What if they didn't get out?
Apparently not.
10 seconds on your stun is too long for Gedrox. I really thought they were gonna get some more. They should get to tier 1 right now, so. Then just tier 1
for
tier 1.
A tower for a tower? No, yeah. Actually not. I don't think they can get this. The creeps are too pushed in. There's not enough of their own. They're not doing enough damage.
War is 17 seconds cooldown. False Promise on cooldown.
Although, here's the Guardian's Greaves. And look at this now. They're not even gonna get to tier 1 here.
They don't wanna go for it. I guess they don't wanna fight 5 into 3. That's 3 into 5. It's This doesn't work.
Well, there you go. In the end, I'm guessing that trade was actually better for LC. Even though they do lose their primary carry, they do manage to kill off a lot.
Yeah, and they got they got a buyback as well popped, so that's some gold as well.
Who's in a gata? That Son's off cooldown, so there's not much he can do here. He does get caught out, but nope, they'll back off.
Not going for it.
And actually, Lycan building up instantly towards a BKB. At least that's what I think he is with that Ogre Club.
It gave me so much. Could even be the new Dragonlance.
Yeah, for Lycan, sure.
New Metaman. Oh, Giga.
Oh, no,
what?
Kefka.
That's just
did he not see the Lina?
I was pretty sure he saw it because there were some heavy pings from Solan exactly on top of him.
Yeah, he had Roar, so they probably would have been able to get the kill
they would have seen it, I think.
But no, they'll just take the tier 1 instead. I'll say fine, we'll grab the tier. No, cool. But no, Priest can't fight this. They're three people. Ultimates are up, so there's not much they can really do to deny anything here.
Indeed, this is just too much. Need to take a step back and maybe look for the tier 2 here. Let's see. Zenigata is coming in. Gedrox can TP in. He's gonna run without them.
They're actually gonna keep pushing here. Four people are up. Is Song up? They can initiate with the Song, and that's exactly what they'll do.
We need to get the Tombstone down so the Magnus can walk in. Okay, he needs to force that forward now if they want to initiate with him here right now. No, they don't want to do so. And LC is like, we're just gonna take the tower then and go back. In the end, not worth it for Priest.
Magnus had a blink. I mean, he had the blink RP ready.
It got on cooldown because he walked too close to the Tombstone.
Well,
he did have a force step as well, so he could have force stepped himself forward and do it with that. But just didn't work.
Oh! No, only gets Pivot. Well,
and he can even false promise himself. Here, there you go. Just stunning time. Trying to TP out, but that's a little bit too big of a dream, I would say.
I'm gonna say that was an acceptable sacrifice, but the problem is he did use false promise, so less acceptable, but still, it's a sacrifice you can make. Although, this is not something you want happening. One player down and they're able to take a tier 1, is that something you want happening?
There's nothing to really stop against it. Whoever died, they can't really fight anymore. They used some of the ultimates as well, and everybody's already split across the map. They all TP'd away, so...
So, what they're saying is epic. Let's take the tier 2, but no. Here comes the reactions from Priest.
Yeah, LC, they just split up the map instantly. If you want to get a tier 2, you're gonna trade one or tier 2s of your own. Let's just take a quick look at the graphs here. LC's still a bit in favor here. Just about 3k in gold. Experience,
XP's
though, is dead
secure,
even.
Though.
It's dead even.
Very interesting game. Problem is, the later they take it, the better Priest gets.
Oh, this might just be something good for LC. They're able to pick up the Arcana rune here on Jellipy. One of the strong heroes to have it on.
Ooh. Bamming that Diabolic Edict, okay.
And it's mostly just for the lighting.
Yeah, they're going to take this tier 2 very easily here.
Also,
nothing.
The reduction on mana is pretty big.
Actually, for a point, just being able to spam out the Diabolic Edict and the Lightning Storms for less mana than
Dull Snow, then it's just all just way too much. And they actually go for the tier 3 here. And just look at this. This is just taking so much damage. They need to do something. It's going to be lost.
They're going to lose it.
And
that
now
was two objectives in the span of like
okay,
two
they're going to try and get the melee Rex here. I think the range is maybe the better target. As you can see,
the
Necrobooks are going
the
for it.
The Necros, yeah. Necros should be able to get
they're going
to
get two?
Easily.
What? They're going to get two
they're
here.
They're going to get the melee Rex.
They're actually going to get the melee Rex here right now first. As they just can't do anything against it. Baby Knight pops his BKB and starts going on bone. But he needs one more hit. There you go. Baby Knight will be able to get it. Now in the middle of them. He needs to get a little bit further away. And
Three man up, but that's the ball.
The 4-man OP there was just not good enough, and now Giga is gonna be found! Gets up the LSA, gets through, but where's gonna be the follow-up damage? It's just not there. Well, LC just took Rex after the game was pretty much that even. Song, canceling TPs, they're still ready here on the backline, they're up there. Can they see the side of... They just see Solan. Oh, the skewer is just on 2, Jellipy is not enough here, as he just tries to turn this one around, and look at this boss promise comes out doing the damage, and he will survive. TPing out, is he able to get back in base? Will he be popped? That's the question. No, he would just get completely healed up to life. Didn't even have to TP out there in the end.
No, for the mana. That was LC showing that they can push without any problems. Naga was unable to do much from the very get-go there. I'm wondering why she didn't pop some earlier.
Maybe I guess he was scared of the BKB on Raiden.
Maybe, but it's like... I mean, that was also a thing. He was able to just completely deny the enemy team from doing anything. Like, they were all focusing him while the racks were just casually being taken in the back lines. What the heck happened there? And this is where Gedrock's just farmlessness is showing. Look, he's not even up to a Battle Fury yet, and this is costing them so much.
Yeah, once they get a Battle Fury, it will become a lot harder for LC, and Power Plus Battle Fury, that will do the damage, that will do the trick for sure.
Although, this is already Rax gone, this is not something you can allow yourself.
At the same time, to be quite honest, Priest, you know, you have an Ember, he's still able to, you know, creep clear pretty damn well. Lina's good at it, Dusk is okay as well. Even the Naga builds certain points. Yeah, Magnus as well. Like, the creep clear is more than available at Priest. If they lose the second lane, then it becomes hard. They need to also maybe contest his Roshan again, maybe get that weird steal again. I still find it weird. I guess you don't have it. But now, they need to be your Fester! What? They saw them walking into Roshan.
Steal again. If he's they're not gonna allow them to... They're not gonna allow them to do this again. Nope, Jellipee's already there.
Thank yeah, they're all blocked in though, but really, what's the initiation right now? Magnus is on the other side of the map.
Yep, gonna work. They're off. This time Rosh goes swimmingly, and this could be a very, very good situation for them. They need to push the advantage.
You see the ping coming out on bottom. Ooh, Kefka. Maybe he can blink in. No. They have a ward out here, making sure that Gedros can't get called out of position here while split pushing. Just as he's in this.
Looking for Baby Knight, he has reverse polarity. Oh, he's even got two targets now. Solan and
Baby Knight. There are sentries here on Solan. Does he find his spider senses tingling?
He probably
they can get a 2-man RP here! Nope. It looks away. It's really good.
This is interesting. Just this?
It just annoyed him a bit.
Oh. There was no... Though, actually, to be honest, looking at the positioning right now, there's nothing really available for Justice to, you know, RP into. RP, give it back into what? Everyone else was just separated everywhere.
But there was a Dusk, but there's not enough to kill him.
Yeah.
So, one Sword Rip would keep him alive.
All basically you're doing is making the Lycan angry, and that's not what you want.
Yeah.
You don't want an angry wolf running around.
And he has an ace as well.
Oh. He's not going to take much damage at all anymore from the Tusk. That's 22 armor.
Yeah, I was kind of expecting them to actually wait for the AC maybe, but...
No,
they're
just going.
There's a Battle Fury now completed.
And that's the last tier 2 for Priest. Not really much they can do to stop that either. Battle Fury's up, but what can they do? Initiating the Magnus onto one person while the rest of the team just stands in the back lines waiting.
Yeah, that's not gonna work. Let's see, what will they do now? At least they just lost a tier 2, like, yeah. That's still okay. Like, losing that is not the worst thing to be have happening. Oh. Courier? No, I don't think they can find it. What is this? This is gonna be Justice's Ultimate Orb. What the hell is he going for with an Ultimate Orb?
Justice Ultimate Orb?
Yeah. What's Ice? Monta? Lincoln. Huh. I maybe expecting either a Refresher or... It was either a Refresher or, in my mind, or a BKB, one of those two. This doesn't really help him. Ultimate Orb was for the old Refresher, so not for the new one. That's double Perseverance plus Recipe.
Buddy doesn't make any sense. Is he maybe trying to go for a Hex?
Yeah.
But then wouldn't you want to get, like, the Mystic Staff first?
No. Ultimate Orb is usually better. It just gives you more overall. Yeah. Like, also give me more tanky. Like, it doesn't really need the extra mana. Like, you already have a 4 staff anyway. You have Arcanas as well. So. What do you need? You don't need anything else.
Buddy
that,
would
so.
Just be weird.
Yeah.
Lickens makes sense, but the problem is it's like...
Okay, this is actually
like,
good to have
makes the most sense.
No, it doesn't help him at all.
Yeah.
Like, against Aurora, I guess. Maybe you can pop it on the Ember, but still. They're not gonna get it before the push is in. They should have gone for something cheaper or something that can help them right now. They need to have the Ember go greedy and have everybody else just make sure that they can't get in there. There's an Edel and some Gigadon, so that will help him out a bit. And Inigata has the Solo Crest. Really, apart from that, Pwn has a Greaves. Has had it for some time now. Also the Blink. He had it actually also that for like another last 5 minutes. So. But the big thing here is
Get
actually...
Gedrops needs a lot more thumb. Yeah, Gedrops needs a lot more thumb than
he does. He really does. That said, for LC, the big thing here is just that Courier. It's bringing 3 completed items here. It's going to be the AC complete, it's going to be the BKB complete as well, and even a full-on 4-step here for Beaver. This is just going to be a nightmare. Like, LC can just run at you. They have over 10k lead right now. Experience is pretty much still dead even because they're pretty much just 5-manning here. That's one problem.
Tough for Priest, very tough for Priest. Such a dire situation for them right now. As Baby Knight disconnects.
Yeah, they are having some mic problems, so... Don't know really what's up with that. Well, having all of that said, ladies and gentlemen, this is the grand final here, actually, between Priest Gaming and London Conspiracy. London Conspiracy got game number 1. They win game number 2 here. They are the winners of our tournament here, and Priest will be... Sally, second place, winning nothing. LC will be winning 25% of the total donations here in the top right. 75% will go to Save the Children, charity organization that helps our children all around the world. Make sure to check out them as well. Don't make a straight up donation to them. But you can also donate to us. You can have a chance of winning the Zeus Arcana. If you're the number 1 on our top donators list of today, at the moment, it's, what's his name again? I think Scottish guy.
Yeah, the Scottish guy.
The Scottish guy with €18.87 was going to win the Zeus Arcane. I'm pretty sure it's actually Exalted. I don't want to say it for 100% sure. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. That's for you guys to find out later. Well, we have even more giveaways. Do the PA is in the Twitch chat. Just check the chat. You will see what to do. And the CM on our Gleam. Our Gleam giveaway over there. I'll post a link into the chat here. Or CM giveaway. Just go there. Good, join it as well. And yeah. I'm Sander, with me is Morality.
Hello.
I guess that's all of it for now. It's just for LC right now, like I said before, it's just go time.
Now is the time where their lineup should really just shine. You know, comes online to their maximum potential. And really, all the items are available. I mean, Lesh is probably the only one who's missing something.
Yeah, he's getting the BKB
better,
now.
Shall we say? He's getting a BKB, but it's not ready yet.
It's ready. Check Courier.
Never mind.
As Morality is trying to figure out what, I guess, Swiss cheese does to you, we're gonna...
What holidays do to you. Anyway. Unfortunately. Back to school on Monday. It's horrible. Necromonim Connor's up on Beastmaster. But really, the push is there. Exactly what they need.
Indeed.
Not much push on Lycan, to be honest. Like, as in, just from his items. But, you know.
You got an AC and flats, so that's pretty much push. It's just, you don't see the Necronomicon book this time around, but they already got one. And him just going for more aura build here, I think, is better as well. And also just having the BKB to fight. Like, there's no physical damage coming out from Priest anytime soon. Like, they have a Battle Fury now. Like, that's really the only real physical damage, apart from Walrus Punch. But, yeah.
And versus, like, the 22 armor that AC is going to give Lycan, that's not too great.
Yeah, he's just A-OK with these items.
And Lycan has reconnected. So, shall we continue?
Indeed. Well, we're still just waiting for...
the confirmation.
Yeah. I think it was Kefka, not Baby Knight. Maybe you could buy a new headset after today. Wouldn't be too bad.
2 more minutes. No problem.
Yeah. So let's see what else is going on here. Something fun in the Twitch chat. It's always fun to check that. What is Revel? No, Revel is something where you do that. Well, guys, also make sure to follow us here, though. You know, we send out content pretty regularly, so make sure to just follow our Twitch channel here. Or if you're listening on YouTube, subscribe to our YouTube as well. Make sure to go to our social media, follow all of that. Pretty much everywhere is Swiss DC. And also follow my co-caster at Morality Claws on Twitch, Twitter. Of course, and me at @_Dota on Twitter as well. Yeah, it's been quiet here. Also, I think I'm going to be streaming the matches, some of the open qualifier matches from pretty much tomorrow. I think I'm going to be following Mama's Boys. Do you know that team?
Not really.
It's the new 4CL team. They renamed, got some new players.
The team shifts in the whole Dota thing just makes me confused sometimes.
Really? I just follow the team that I like.
No, it's not really confusing to be honest.
Mama's Boys, its name.
It's more just, I don't know how to put it. There's too many team shifts. That's a good point, way to put it.
No, it's not like, in the top teams. It's just after the just before the roster locks, if something happens. And for the lower teams, okay. Yeah, shifting there is. It's, but no, even now, remember, it's less.
Do I have to remind you? Remind you back to the times when there were no roster locks.
Yeah, that was a lot more. But it's now just really with the lower tier teams that are not able to qualify for the qualifiers of Shanghai. Like, if you don't qualify for that, then you get pretty much instant disbands as well as...
We say lower tier teams. These are like 6-7k players as well. It's...
Yeah, but still, it's just in professional scene, you're a tier 3 team. And that's the problem. Like, if you have something like Mama's Boys, who was Bycat, Hook, Sexy Bamboo, Jabster, and Saxa joining the the open qualifier, you gotta be strong, because that's a tier 2 team.
Yeah. I mean, really, it's... a bit annoying, but you know, it's just, the thing is that the Dota, unlike most esports, actually, unlike you know, normal sports, are just based around the top teams and not really focused on the lower teams. So to everyone watching, thank you for supporting the
Priest Gaming and LC, but still, LC is a pretty big organization. They got dirt in a previous tournament, so
not bad. And they did they did go pretty far in the open qualifiers, I believe, of the international. In the qualifiers themselves.
Not 100% sure. I don't think LCA actually had a team then. It was already Golden Boys. Yeah, the Greek roster left.
Sorry, that was another team. Never mind. Still, tier 2. Tier 2 Dota. The little guys who are probably better than the most of us.
A little bit, just a little bit. Smoke is up here. Pretty classic here from LC. Having one person in the front, everybody else smoke behind it, and just looking for the initiation. Gatterbox completely blown up here.
And that's all the counter push there is, other than Naga, of course, but you know.
No buyback! This might just be game.
This is definitely Rax.
150 bolted. No, he's not gonna make it. We're gonna get another Rax.
This is going to be Rax. Like,
even if he gets the RP here, what's going to be the follow-up? There's only some magical damage.
There's not even a good RP right now. There's no good targets right now. They're all split up.
You're going to get two at most. Maybe three if he goes now, but he's not close enough. You know, and there's still Tombstone as well.
Who's in the back lines? Like, Kefka's in the back lines just waiting. Just look. He's... well, he doesn't have Raw, so he's...
but
not
he has Solar Quest. And power is up on Pwn though, but yeah, it's already too late. They're gonna get it, they're just gonna back off now. They're gonna look for Zenigata, he should pop the song and get out. Yeah. He knows
this is what happens, you take out just one person and the whole fight can go haywire.
But that's the one hero they 100% need is him. Maybe even over the Magnus. But yeah, even if you lose Magnus, it was also lane of ranks, but still, they got a chance, they still have a chance. It's just
he's
a lot harder.
Rex. Yeah.
It just went
deeper creeps on two lanes.
Like it just went from what is it, 40% chance to like 5%, or 5 to 10, in my eyes, to win this one.
Like we need some 322 throws here to happen if like.
The Aegis is reclaimed though. Throw. But now it's the question:
well,
do LC want to push here? They got a DD though. They got a DD,
like,
baby.
Will else you throw all the G style?
I think
the answer is very no. Probably
I think
not.
they would just go try take the tier 3. Even if they just get the tier 3, lose one or two, it's okay for LC.
Waiting for the creeps and
summons are there, but they're taking a lot of damage and they're actually gonna go down before they can reach the tower here maybe. No. It's actually just a little bit of life left on next one.
Oh, the Battle Fury is showing its worth.
But now Zenigata, he's too far forward, he's gonna die here. Well, that was a little bit weird here, but Jellypy needs to go down here, doesn't have... Oh, he actually gets punched back here, it was funny to see. As with the skewer, but this is not the fight for Priest, I need to buy back here. Jellypy is taking a lot of damage, but will just barely survive here in the end. Oh, Baby Knight, he's gonna go down, that was too far. They need to get the tier 3, they were focusing too much on the heroes here. We're gonna get the TPs out though. Let's see, Biver. Don't think they can find him here. Jellypy is also gonna be okay.
Did some damage to the tier 3, but no real objectives gained in that short engagement. In fact, they lose the main core. So well worth it for Priest here. Good defense.
Yeah, that would be a nice 2k swing here at least. One problem is they did lose some damage here. It still surprises me that LC didn't just pressure the tower a bit more. Lycan also went into the tier 4, while his team was absolutely not backing him up.
Like, his team was still back at the tier 3. At this point, I think Lycan was just diving a bit too much at that here. Thinking he could go in a bit aggressive, but...
he could be ended, and he just got Laguna out.
Yeah. Lina says, well, thanks for the free damage.
Yeah. Question is, what's Lina got? Okay, this actually answers the question. It's gonna be the Yules? Nope.
Well, you know, she can't really go out.
Okay, she's gonna go sentries.
Gonna go sentries, guys. Next level build, Jesus.
And Beastmaster gets a kill here.
That's not good, because Magnus is vital. He does have buyback, though.
Yeah, so. 70 seconds, but has buyback. And maybe LC want to do something with this. I don't think they can be there in time with... they need Lycan there, that's wrong. He does have shapeshift if he wants to run there, but...
Yep, there's buyback.
Yeah, they're just brushing it right now with just... Necrolux and some dwarves. They'll get it.
Still doing a bit of damage as well. I mean, it's now down to less than a third of its health.
Yeah, for LC, the game plan now stays the same. They just got out the buyback, just... Stay back a bit, wait for Roshan and try to get a pick off somewhere and then push it to the base. For Priest, it's all about trying to stick a little bit more closer together and don't have someone out on his own like Justice here is. And have someone always behind it. But you can even just put Magnus back in the base, to be quite honest. It's not even worth farming on him. You look
of course,
he kills the siege creep and gets fucking 30 gold, like you might as well stay in the base and then just give the farm to Giga.
60%, yeah, it's like 60% gold. And the thing is, they know that this side of the map currently is pretty clear, so they can afford a bit of, you know, excursions.
But you don't want to get the farm on the hero that gives just 60% reduction on them. Like, and give it to Gedrox, give it to Giga or whatever. It's just not worth farming it.
Well, now he's got the reduction is off, so he'll be able to get something here.
That's true.
And the question is still, what will he do with this ultimate orb?
I'm gonna expect Lincolns? Like, what else?
Like Hex, but Hex is still so far off.
It's
get yourself out of the crit.
It's still surprising me that you went there. It's just weird.
Still there. I mean, the problem is, if he gets fixed, he notices. There's no, I'm not going to risk it anymore.
You could have gone on the BKB by now.
Good point, actually. Without the ultimate AWP, he would have had a BKB. And that would have been much better, since no disable on him is... not going to be a very good situation for LC.
Yeah, that will just give him a lot more space. Even just getting... Was it the... a Ghost Scepter? So you can just walk into range of the totem and then just jump them. It's also worthwhile.
That's a Lincoln's.
Okay, Roshan is up. Side of LC know it. Now they just need to secure it. I don't think there are any wards here on the side.
Spook. No. This is critical, Priest. This could be very interesting as Priest.
They know that the Naga Siren ultimate thing is walking there.
They already see the Naga. Now everyone's been spotted out. They should recognize by now that what's going on, but... Yeah, they give up the Rosh. They decide they don't want to risk this at all.
At the same time, Pwn is going to be found and he needs a stun. Keep him alive. Okay, now they need to set up, but the totem is on the cliff and they don't really have anything to do with it. There are a lot of slide of fist, they're doing the damage here, but it's not gonna really work out too much here.
Then it got to war 4.
Yeah. There was no one to deal the damage to, that was a little bit troublesome.
And this should be free rush. As it did look like a good setup for priests.
They actually got the gem? Just one of them drop it?
What happened to Roshan? Where was he going?
Went for a little bit of a walk.
Anyway, no, but as Priest did look like they had a really good setup going. The thing is, I don't know who was it that walked forward and spotted nearly all of them. I think it was Biver.
It was Biver walking forward and four-stepping back.
Yeah, Biver walking forward, four-stepping back, and they knew the jig was up at that point, decided not to risk Rosh anymore and take a fight instead. Grab a kill, and it was a good kill. Killing off Nargis, very good. Problem is, 10 seconds until she's back.
But then another minute for the ultimate, and a minute is not enough to stop this push. Essentially, they can't defend it, but now, like, you might as well ignore her, pretty much. Just a snare once BKB is up is probably the most worthwhile thing out of her.
Ember now has a Daedalus, so there's something there to let them do damage, but here goes the tier 3.
But the damage is pretty hard, but they need to do something now.
This is just definitely creatures.
Oh, Justice, no, he's found! Are they? They're just keeping him here. They need to do something with him. They need to get him back, and so he can blink forward. Same time, they're fighting in the back. Now, Baby Knight's getting low. Baby Knight's not getting low enough. Jellypee also see Aegis, and even with the BKB on, there's just no damage coming out from there. They need to fortify, and it's not going to work out.
There's the Megas. I think this is game over.
They need to get some return kills here, maybe. Jellypee. Oh, ooh, the damage! The cleave! Great.
No, Jellypee will be able to heal up though.
Yeah, Solus is the target they want in there. Oh, Kefka, a little bit aggressively forward there. Is his team there to back him up? Yes, it is, and he will just barely survive there with 40 HP. Vi pretty much helping him out, and there's gonna be the blink.
And he's out.
Nope, that was not correctly guessed there from Justice.
And Megas. What can you say about this? This is not something you can defend from.
You at least have the cleave, like, it could be worse. It's not the worst lineup to defend against it, but you don't have any auras.
Justice is just dying to this. He's not, he can't do anything. It's like he needs help from Zenigata. At least Gedrox is able to clear these creeps incredibly quickly. Problem is, they're going to be so pressured. Yeah, they're going to be so pressured from just having to clear all these creeps out. LC will be able to just take them in a weakened state.
Yeah, the problem, like I said, they need some kind of auras coming their way. They just only got the drums and the healers right now, but they need radiance, they need anything they can get their hands on, AC as well.
I mean, look at this, they're all focused on killing the creeps so hard, they can't focus on anything else.
Yeah, they're stuck there. Honestly, if LC won, they could just wait 5 minutes.
Yeah, they could.
Just farm up the entire map and just get him more items. So just get the side on Jellypee though. I think that's the only thing.
Megas
really
are devastating. Megas are devastating.
Let's see. Nothing else really. That skill brush was already something he had. So. Yeah. I'll see. What are they waiting for? There's a green thing drawn there from Baby Knight. I guess he wants to farm, push out all the lanes.
Look at this, Illusion's actually just pushing in on their own. It's like, this is what happens, you can't neglect anything.
Gedrox is getting a lot of farm though. Can buy a second Chrysalis if he wants. Probably will be a better career though.
Problem is that LC probably know what's going on. And look at this, they're just walking around on the enemy high ground. Oh, actually, so they're
going to
be able
to. They just completely healed. So that doesn't work. And now the rock comes in on Giga here, but there comes out the song to save him as well as the snowball. Take a step back.
Hello. Oh.
The episode on Zenigata. Not able to get up the ensnare because of it.
This is it.
There's Sona taking a lot of damage. No. He stops his ultimate there and will now use it on Jellypee, but he is also glimmered up. They can't really focus him down too much. He's taking a lot of damage though, but it's not going to be enough as now Zenigata is going to be turned upon. Giga is gonna get hit by the Earth Spike here. He goes down. Lightning is doing a lot of work. Gadrox is just getting a tombstone in the backlines, not dealing any damage. It's not gonna work out. And even the bash.
Wow. Toad just wants to get away from this all, and very well played by LC, winning the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament.
And indeed.
In a spectacular fashion. More of a very pushy fashion, to be honest.
Yeah, with that, let's just check the total amount of donations right now. Let's see if it reloads, let's see if it updated. It absolutely did not.
Well.
Should be
Thank
about...
Thank you to everyone who donated, though.
Yeah, Scottish guy. Let's see if I can find him. I hope it's in the Twitch list. So, yeah. Well, anyhow, congratulations here to London Conspiracy for winning our tournament here. For Save the Children. It's a charity organization. Make sure to check them out. With that...